He is my king. King is my one. Yes, he's my father. Yes, he's my son. I can talk to him, cause he understands everything I go through and everything I am. He's my support system. I can't live without him. The best thing since sliced bread is his kiss, his hugs, his lips, his touch. And I just want the whole world to know about my black brother. I love you and I'll never try to hurt you.
Thank you for watching London Live, Love, and Laugh. Oh my goodness, I got so much to tell you guys about and why I was away for a little season. So stay tuned. I'm sitting here in my living room just relaxing, just chilling, and I decided to come and tell you guys about my little encounter, my tooth, my killer toothache that I had this past week. It went on for about a week, something like that, and I could not get no rest from it. I was just irritable, period. And let me tell you some of the details of what happened. For starters, I already have sensitive gums, so me bleeding in on the gums or etc. when I brush my teeth was nothing new to me. Happens at least twice a year or something like that. It's not often, but it does happen that I have sensitive gums. And I was just sitting there and I was like, okay, why in the world are my gums bleeding like this? Didn't pay it no attention, and then the pain started, and then the next thing you know, then there was fever, and then I was like, okay, something's a little irregular. So I took something, I felt a little better a day or two, and now we're at day three, and then all of a sudden now, aside from feeling better, I noticed a little slight, like I couldn't hear. And then everybody I was telling them about, they was like, oh, that has to something to do with your toothache or something to do with the fact that your tooth was bothering you because now you can't hear or whatever. So that's ear, nose, and throat or something like that all goes together. And deaf, y'all. I was going deaf and I could not hear. It wasn't that I could not completely hear. But it was like stuffing cotton in your ears and then trying to do what is normal to you or hear. It was just weird to me. Then I started getting headaches. And then because it was so hard for me to chew, the last meal or so that I had forced myself to get down, I wind up throwing up everything because it could not stay down. It just would not stay down. And I was just irritable. I was feeling horrible, and finally they had to call an ambulance to come get me because, you know, I'm just stubborn. I'll just keep going till I'm on my last limb. And they called the ambulance to come get me, get to the emergency room, and they had me on all kind of painkillers, which was wonderful for my situation. They gave me all of these crazy painkillers. First, they doped me up with Motrin, and then about a few hours later, because I was literally in there like 6 hours, they gave me some Percocets, and I was sitting there just drooling. By the time they had called me, I was leaned over, slopped over, just drooling. I didn't even know who I was, where I was, what my name was. You could have said anything to me, and I would not have known. Nothing. But they gave me that, and then the doctor basically let me know that there was nothing wrong with my teeth, because I know that my wisdom teeth were growing in, and I thought maybe, you know, there was something wrong with that, my wisdom teeth, because all of them are coming at the same time. So she just suggested to me that I get them pulled sometime soon, but overall there was nothing wrong with my teeth at all, except for a little mild gum infection. A little tooth infection that almost killed me. Oh boy, that was a mess. So y'all already know. I don't ever have to worry about going through nothing else like that again, because believe you me, we're gonna stay up to par, because that right there, going deaf and vomiting and all of that over a tooth or a little gum infection, no, sweetie, that's not happening, not no more, not another further. So y'all that have been wondering what was wrong with me, where I've been at, and why I haven't been doing anything on the web, etc., not answering emails and all of that such, now you know why. So yeah, that's basically it. Check out my new blog. I have a new blog. I shut the other one down that I had once before, and then I transferred a new name, or I'm doing everything under a new name, as I should say. And you can find that on www.themichaellondonshow.wordpress.com. Again, that's www.themichaellondonshow.wordpress.com. Also, join my online site. You can go to www.michaellondon.webs.com. That's www.michaellondon.webs.com. Remember, if the need is great, then the subject is worthy. Live, love, and laugh, and watch London. Peace.
Young people going to stand up real quick. Come on. Come on, we got to stand.